Hello, my name is Jason Wagner, solution engineer at Eide Bailly. This video is designed to highlight the benefits and functionality of the Eide Bailly non-controlling interest SuiteApp for NetSuite. Eide Bailly is a top 20 CPA and consulting firm with offices across the United States. Eide Bailly offers a wide range of world-class offerings, including audit and assurance, tax, wealth planning, managed services, and digital and technology solutions. As of this recording, Eide Bailly has been awarded the NetSuite Partner of the Year 6 out of the last 7 years. Organizations that manage multiple companies have more complexities than those with only one subsidiary. From operational requirements to reporting requirements, navigating how to manage this in your ERP system can be difficult and manual, depending on the ERP software you are using. The NetSuite application allows all subsidiaries to be managed and reported under one umbrella. With NetSuite, there is no need to log out of one company and into another when performing your daily activities. Creating consolidated financial statements across your enterprise within NetSuite could not be simpler. Running consolidated financial statements out of the base NetSuite application assumes you own 100% of all subsidiaries in the org chart. Well, what if you have a subsidiary or subsidiaries that you have a partial ownership in? This is where the Eide Bailly non-controlling interest SuiteApp can help automate the recording and reporting of minority interest subsidiaries. This slide shows an example of an org chart that includes some partially owned subsidiaries. In this example, the Denver subsidiary is owned partially by two different parent subsidiaries, US East with 20% and US West with 80%. Along with that, US West also has 80% ownership in the San Francisco subsidiary. Without the non-controlling SuiteApp, calculating and creating the adjusting entries for proper reporting of this partial ownership would be manual. This slide highlights the key features of the non-controlling interest SuiteApp. First, it supports both equity and consolidation methods depending on how and where you want the adjusting entries to be created. I'll explain this in more detail in a little bit. Second, it automatically will create, calculate, and book the non-controlling interest entries. Third, it allows for the calculation and posting to be reversed and rerun if necessary. Fourth, it, as shown in the subsidiary chart earlier, it can allocate gains and losses across multi-parent ownership. Fifth, it allows for the flexibility in setting posting rules among accounts, subsidiaries, and periods. And lastly, full audit tracking of how the calculation was derived allows for full visibility into the process. In this final slide before we dive in, I'll explain the primary reporting methods used by the SuiteApp. The first method is equity. This method is typically used for subs partially owned and not controlled by your enterprise. With this method, the application will post a simple two-line adjusting journal entry into the books of either the parent sub or the elimination subsidiary belonging to the parent. The other method is the consolidation method that is typically used when there is ownership share over 50%. This method comes with two options. The first is a straight consolidation reporting method. This is typically used when you only need to provide consolidated financials. The other option is for a full reporting option. Along with the prior method, it will also allow for individual financials to be run for each subsidiary. You can decide which method best suits each non-controlling subsidiary. So with this information, let's go ahead and get into a view of the non-controlling interest SuiteApp. Okay, so as you can see, I'm already logged in to my NetSuite minority interest environment. Once the SuiteApp is installed, you'll notice in the very top, there's a few different task menus that appear within your environment of NetSuite. The first thing I want to kind of cover real quick is the list of where you configure the consolidation details of your minority interest subsidiaries. So on this list, you can see the relationship of the upper level subsidiary to the lower level subsidiaries. The one you really want to point out are the ones that have the percentage ownership where it's under 100%. So you can see here that for US West has 80% ownership of the Denver subsidiary, whereas the US East subsidiary owns 20% of that same Denver subsidiary. To the right-hand side is where it talks about those different reporting methods that we talked about earlier, as well as the GL coding you can define when you go through the configuration and implementation of the non-controlling SuiteApp. To actually run a minority interest job for the month is very simple to do. I'm going to go ahead and go into the run minority interest. I'm going to create a new job. That's essentially all you're going to do is choose the period that you would like to run the calculations for. So at any time throughout the month, you can run this particular minority interest job, and it will do the calculations for you to give you more up-to-date consolidated financial statements. Again, you can run it as many times you want throughout the month. It'll always override the previous one that was run. So look at a prior one that I had run previously. I'm going to go ahead and open up the list of the ones that have been run previously. So as you can see here, I've already run the minority interest job for April of 2021, and it shows the status of a processing has been completed. Now, as the status is run, it'll continue to update that particular status until it's been completed. I'm going to go ahead and click on View to view this particular April entry that was created. So as you can see here, it gives you a lot of information on this particular screen. On the right-hand side, the first thing I want to point out is the consolidation chart. If I open this up, this is going to show you the relationship and the structure of what was run when that particular month's consolidation was processed. So the top portion is really just showing you a high-level enterprise view of the subsidiaries and their structure. Below there, it shows the process order of the calculations that were run to get to the ending results. Since you could have tiered relationships, this really is a graphical view and representation of how those particular processes were run. I'm going to go ahead and close that. And you can see, since this job has already been completed, I've got this execution log that I can then view on my particular screen. So I'm going to go ahead and select it. And as you can see, once it opens this up, it really gives you a full audit tracing of what took place when this particular job was run. So the first thing that it did, as you can see here, is that it deleted the previous minority interest journal entries that were created for the month of April because I had run it prior. And then down below, it's now showing me the different steps that it took to come up with those calculations. So you can see here, here's step one, here is step two. And again, as you scroll down, you'll notice it's showing you all of the different status that took place. So in this case, this is showing you where the Denver subsidiary rolled up to the US West. It shows the total income that was realized or lost that was realized and what was allocated to the US West subsidiary. Along with that, it also shows you the journal entries that were created for that particular entry within NetSuite. So you can see it created journal entries 1364 and 1365. Which to the left of that, you can see, I can view those particular journal entries individually if I want to as well. So I'm going to go ahead and close this. And what I'll do is I'm going to go ahead and open up one of these particular journal entries. So I'm going to open up 1365 because that was one of the entries that was on that audit log. And you can see here that it brings up my journal entry screen, the typical one out of NetSuite. And you can see here, this entry was booked to the US West subsidiary where we're allocating the Denver minority interest income that's appropriate to us. So again, these account numbers are being affected, and those are defined when you're doing the configuration within the application. So the last step then that you could do is if I go under minority interest, I've got these additional reports that I can run as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and run the minority interest consolidated income statement report. And you can see here on the bottom, I'm running it for the US West consolidated view only, and I'm running it for just the month of April. And you can see here on the top that because of the entries and the accounts that I've selected, I've got a net gain or loss from my different subsidiaries. So now from here, I can then drill down and view that particular entries. So now if I drill down, there's the two journal entries that were affected. And again, since the US West has minority interest in both San Francisco and Denver, if I open up each of these individual journals, you'll notice that here's journal entry one, where we're recognizing the gain or loss from the San Francisco office. And then if I close this, you'll notice that this entry was the one where we're recognizing the gain or loss of the Denver facility. That concludes the demonstration. If you would like more information on the Eide Bailly non-controlling interest SuiteApp, please reach out to us by phone at 844-476-8957 or at productsales@eidebailly.com.